first one that's going to be speaking tonight is Chief Security Officer, Mr. Frank Sosebee.
Frank!
I'm going to hand out some safety tips. I'm doing safety tips and car safety and such as that. This right here, just take this home with you. Look it over. It is some safety tips for you at your house. It may come in handy. It may save your life. What I am going to go over here, and if you'd like a copy of what I'm actually going to speak on tonight, I'll be happy to email this to you. My email's on the back of the pages here. But safety, especially in areas of Dawson County, for example, without miles such as that, and where you park your vehicle, you got to be aware when you come out of a store, you may see a large van, a large truck. Now I move a lot, so you're going to be following me everywhere. Now, I do not stand still. At work, I do not stand still. I actually came from work today. I just changed the shirt, and I apologize for that. But we got 11 new re-entry guys in today, and that's very important to me. They come back to society and save us a lot of money. So, but at the outlet mall, think about your car and you're parked in a parking lot. And you go back out and there's a van there. It's got a slide door on the side of it. And you're not thinking, you're on your cell phone, you're walking up to the car. And all of a sudden, somebody slides the door open, snags you and jerks you right into that car. That happens. That's an abduction. We have this problem now where a lot of the young ladies that are ages from 12 to 18 are in a sex trafficking out here nowadays. You can see this. Go online, look it up. It's sad. It's very sad what these ladies and these young girls are going through. So the first thing we need to really think about is awareness. Be aware of your area that you're around. Be aware of who may be standing beside you, behind you. You never know when you may become a potential victim of a snatching, of an armed robbery, somebody coming to stick a gun in your back. You never know what's going to happen. Be aware of your surroundings. The second that I want to talk about is use of your sixth sense. And what I call this is a gut feeling. Everybody's had this gut feeling. You know, you've been in a position where all of a sudden something's telling you, you don't need to do that. You don't need to do that. That happens. Go with that gut instinct. Know that something's awareness again, that's around you. Be aware of your presence. Know what's around you. You just don't never know who may show up. An example, Ben, on a call one time, I had a shotgun stuck in my chest, didn't even know the guy was there coming out of the woods on me. That happened. That's a true story. Thank God I'm still here. But be aware. Use that sixth sense. Learn to trust the powers that you have inside yourself. Know what's around you. Another thing is never forget to escape. Always attempt to run. I know a lot of times I say, just give in. Don't give in. Fight to your last breath. Don't give in on anything. Never, never. There's statistics on that. It says if you will fight, the good opportunity that you're going to survive. Very good opportunity. Don't give in to anybody. Don't be a victim. Just fight. Another one is your right, like I was saying, your right to fight. It's important to understand that you can and should defend yourself physically. No matter how diligently we practice awareness and avoidance techniques, we may find ourselves in a physical confrontation. That can happen. It's happened to me. I don't know if anybody else has been a victim or has been in a physical confrontation. I'm sure that Jeff and Tony and Jeff has. And Marcus back here, he's from Munkin County. But I'm sure somebody at one point in time in your life, growing up, you've been in a confrontation. You know what it's like to fight. Learn when you're in this battle. Learn to flee. Get away from these people. For example, if your attacker comes up and grabs you and you get away and you take off running, screamed at the top of your lungs. Help, help. If you pick a rock up, bust a window out, it doesn't matter. That's your life you're talking about. You've got to get away from these attackers. The next thing is pepper spray. I don't know how many ladies or gentlemen here touch pepper spray. The little canisters may have any keychains and stuff like that. I can give you some pros and cons on pepper spray. Have you ever tested it in downwind and all of a sudden it comes right back in your face? It will do that. Give you another example. If you're toting it in your purse, you got an attacker coming up on you, how quick can you get it out and spray it? Think about it. And I'll give you an example. It doesn't work on everybody. The very first time I sprayed somebody with pepper spray and with two other officers, we all three sprayed him at one time. All they done was clench down, wipe his eyes, and said, boys, that don't work. So that happened. The very first time I had to spray somebody. And we hadn't had it maybe 2 weeks. So pepper spray doesn't work all the time. The key to this is safety and your survival. So I won't give another example of something here. A home invasion. I know a lot of times we hear this on the news, but it can happen in this county. Home invasion can happen anywhere. Do you have a secure area in your house, I call it a safe zone, that you can go to, that you can lock a door, that you may have a cell phone with you that you can dial 911 and call for help? And another thing is, have the pepper spray with you. There's no wind inside your house. You can get them that way. And you will survive. Get help coming to you. Next one, and I know everybody's heard of this before, carjackings. Carjackings are predominant. They happen especially down in Atlanta. What happens at a carjacking is the offender will come at a 45 degree angle at you, blindside. And I know what everybody knows on the blindside, you're looking on your car, you may try to pull over before and somebody nearly hits you. You got a blindside, both sides. They can sneak up on you like that. And what they're going to do, they're going to jump in the passenger side. Or they're going to jump in and grab you and drag you out. So you got to be very careful about this. The key at an intersection is to make sure your doors are locked on your cars at all times. That is very important. You will survive a carjacking by doing that. Travel tips. Just and y'all may think I'm crazy about this, but just think about it. Everybody knows what a wedge is with a block of wood. Say you go to a motel. You get in this motel, and all of a sudden somebody, a butler comes up. He's bringing you your food that you ordered, but it's not the right one. He knows you're in there. You make it to the bathroom. That wedge is stronger than that door. That wedge just slid into a door will stop an intruder. You can't push open on that wedge. Thank you. I needed that. So it's just something to think about when you go, especially if you're by yourself, a lady by herself traveling. Just be careful. The last thing I have is about cyberspace. Social media for these kids out here. This stuff goes on all the time. There's predators out there online. I'll give you an example of something else, even worse, is terrorists. There are drawing our young kids in by cyberspace. And it's scary to know that kids are out here nowadays, they're more apt to get on a computer, texting or anything else, than going out here playing in a sandbox like we used to a long time ago, get on a swing set. All that's changed now. Everybody's gone to the computer. You've got to watch your kids. You've got to protect your kids. Everybody in here, I'm sure, has got a kid. Some may not, but I know everybody in here. Some's small, growing up. We've got kids. If you love them enough, you'll take care of them. Now, that's all the tips that I've got. Adam handed out a lot of tips here for you to review. Please read them. If you have any questions or anything about any of this, I'll be glad to give this to you, let you look at it. my name is Frank Sosebee. I am a Republican running for sheriff in this county, and I appreciate you both.
What's the open carry laws as it applies to the outlet mall? What are the open carry laws as it applies to the outlet mall since it's private property?
You can tell the guy. Now, someplace, I'm going to tell you a place over in Gainesville. It's called Wild Wings. They've got a sign at the front door that says not to bring a gun in there.
Right.
Yes. You cannot go, they've got it right there at the front door. When you walk up to Wild Wings, you cannot go in there.
Well, no concealed.
If you've got a permit, tote your gun. I'm a big, big fan of toting a gun off duty.
Governor Deal signed that law.
Yes, sir. And tote you, if you tote guns, ladies, men, anybody. And I'm gonna give Jeff Johnson a toot on the horn for this. He teaches firearms. Great instructor.
There you go.
So, and I appreciate that. So, yes, you need to tote a gun. That is too much danger out here nowadays. Anybody else?
Frank, I know you probably need to get out of here tonight.
Well, I don't know yet. I'm sorry. My daughter's got a brand new car, and she's down in Atlanta, and all of a sudden that car quit running. So, and that's it.
So he came here first.
These tips are very important. Yeah, I went over these tips.
So we appreciate that, Frank. And we understand if you need to get to her, please do so. Thank you, Frank.
Any more questions for us? Thank you.